Ladies and gentlemen, this next bout of the evening takes place in the Your Flyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing SVG and bringing to the cage a record of 2 wins and 4 defeats. Give it up for Kian McCartan!
I can tell by your charm and your arm, but I'm looking for the one. Have you seen her? I sang it to her. She had the ass like Serena, Trina, Gina, for Lopez. 4 kids, and I gotta take all the bad ass to show kids. Okay, 2 kids, but then they got their friends. I would've been the kids, but y'all got a bed. We all went to bed, and then I had to lay. If you're fucking with this girl, then you better be paid. You know why? Too much to touch her. From what I heard, she got a baby by Buster. My best friend said she used to fuck with Usher. I don't care what none of y'all say, I still love her. Now I ain't saying she a gold nigga. She ain't messing with the
And introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, representing Team Torres, presenting Shay Cleveland!
Excited to see this one, Paul. I'll check my biases at the door. I just have a lot of time for Shay. He's been training since he was 12, 13 years old. He was fighting today. He was training the gi on Tuesday night. You love to see it.
Good
you
man.
Love to see it.
Yeah, he had his first two bouts in September, a win and a loss. Straight in the action here with Kian McCartan, who's been racking up the experience. 6 fights to his name already. Kian McCartan has 3 losses by submission on his record. So you'd imagine that Shay Cleveland will be possibly looking at that as an avenue to victory.
Yeah, Shay's a blue belt. He's done quite well in competitions. He got a silver in the Nogi Irish Open and adult there a while ago. He went up a weight division or two just to be able to get matches. So But he's a very crisp and confident striker. That debut that he had in Ireland kind of really showed the striking pedigree that he has. And then loss in the UK showed he's competing at flyweight, but he's waking up on the day at flyweight. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
some of these guys are cutting.
Yeah.
And I know Kian is the same in that situation as well. So I'm glad to see both of them get matches against body types that are the same as the other.
Young guys, both still growing, you know. Yeah, a really good first victory for Shay on Virtus 1 via TKO against Owen Teague. And he'll be looking to add to that now today. He's almost around to the back now.
He's got
that
nice
headlock position, that scarf hold.
Yeah, nice reaction from Kian there in terms of looking for that. Interesting back step. Is he looking for an entry into the saddle here? I don't think so. But it's a strange split mount position that Kian has right now. It's actually... looks quite effective, to be honest. He's looking for a wee Americana here in Shay.
Yeah, he's looking to isolate that right arm, isn't he? And Shay climbing the cage and having a roll.
Shay's just taking the pressure off that massively.
Excellent.
What
defense.
A scramble.
Excellent.
And now he's in a front headlock position of his own.
You know, how it is. Sometimes you got to get creative in those unorthodox positions.
Yeah, there could be a guillotine on here, Paul, to be honest. I'm not too sure. Here's the striking we're talking about on the disengagement. Nice knee to the body, good head control as well. But Keane is relentless here on some of these takedowns. He has the hands clasped, but Shea's in the perfect pivot in the groove of the cage here.
McCartan giving a smile to Dave from Fansview MMA, who is taking his photo. Excellent. Look at that, bouncing straight back to the feet. He's feeling good. Now he's found his back is almost taken. He's just got 30 seconds left to work here. So
he's done well at building himself up to his knees here, but Keane has tracked it very well. That's something that's good to see.
Yeah.
Good back control here
really
as well.
Good habit.
We're down into the last 15 seconds of this round here, Paul. It looks like he is going to try taking the other way here to get the hook. Shea's using his feet against the cage well. He's not digging the toes in or anything like that, but good nice high, you wouldn't call it a high guard, but keeping the knees close to the chest there to be able to prevent a back being taken and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Great round between both. Keane probably just ahead in terms of his control and the takedowns and stuff like that, and you have to count that as a near submission attempt with the Americana. It's not necessarily that, oh, was that close? It's you made him react and you made him escape the position and react from the position.
Exactly. Proactive.
I was wincing. As a person with terrible mobility in my shoulders, I was wincing watching that. So good reaction from Shea. He was able to transition out and get the top position. But
I'm with you on that one. I like to keep the elbows in.
Actually, we're getting old now, you see. You know what I mean? These boys are made of rubber.
You're getting old. I'm already there, my friend. Possible entry to the Master 4 category next
what?
Year.
Really?
Possibly.
What's
I don't
that, the year you turn 40,
I'm
is it?
44.
You're 44, Paul.
Yeah,
you look 34.
Since last
if
September.
Even.
My back doesn't feel 34. It just took me nearly 2 hours to drive here from Limavady this morning. And 3 hours to drive up to Strabane yesterday, so this rockstar lifestyle is catching up with me.
Wow, Shea Cleland throwing a head kick. Keane ducks straight under it into this double leg position.
You can't blink when you're watching footballs.
No, and he did start to seem a wee bit more comfortable there in that initial position. He's taking a nice left overhook here. He's going to hit the throw, or he's going to look for the throw if anything else. And I've said this about someone else before as well. Shea Cleland with a very stylish pair of shorts here, engaged. You know that brand from South from Australia.
Mm.
Adesanya has a part of. There's a nice shot there from Cleland.
Mixed that little front kick out there just to get his opponent's attention. Carton's relentless with this wrestling.
He's very, very consistent with it. And I suppose when you see who's in his corner, Richie Smullen, the man that would run through a wall for a takedown, it doesn't really surprise me, to be honest. You know, I'd just be worried about where he's leaving his head in some of those positions when he's persistent on coming in, looking to be able to take a leg out from under him. Or, you know, he's doing very well at scaling himself up and down Cleland's body here in relation to the takedowns, but I think he's going to try a throw here again. Oh, step and knee. That one hurt. I think we've just got a reaction out of Keane here from Shea.
Shea needs to keep the distance.
Big strikes here. He's going to sweep that leg from under him. Oh, my goodness. What a jumping armbar from Keane. He landed on his head a wee bit.
He's on this arm. It's deep. It's hyperextended. And
he's
got the
tapping.
Tap.
Oh, my goodness. What a finish and reaction from Keane. That's an all-time finish there. Shea's arm is hurt here because it took him a while to be able to get the tap. That fight was headed towards a finish, and he jumped for broke there. He went for broke. A nice flying triangle attempt that was transitioned into an armbar. These are two names that you're going to hear a lot of over the next couple of years in Ireland. But in terms of the reaction and how he just caught that in the moment, Keane McCartan, that is a fantastic finish.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner after 1 minute and 29 seconds of the second round due to a flying armbar, Kian McCartan!